So we got Anthony Ryder from South Lyon, Michigan, recently selected as the Lions 2020 Fan of the Year. He has a passion about sports broadcasting.
With the 112th selection in the 2021 NFL Draft, the Detroit Lions select Amon-Ra St. Brown, wide receiver, USC. One pride, baby! Brad Holmes and the Detroit Lions have less than a month to decide what they're going to do in the 2024 draft, what prospects are going to be on their board, what players they want to add to this team, and how they're going to construct this team for the future success of the franchise. And one of the ways that they're going to do that, and one of the ways they've been doing that over the last couple of weeks, has been draft visits with the team, where they bring in a prospect, they fly them into Allen Park, they bring them into the facilities, they tour them around, they interview them, and they get to know the prospect as closely and as detailed as possible. And today, we're going to take a look at the players that the Lions have been interviewing, the players that have visited Allen Park and the Detroit Lions, as well as kind of take a look and see if we can have some takeaways about either positions that the Lions are focusing on, archetypes and types of players the Lions want to bring in, as well as who potentially may be on the board for the Detroit Lions at 29, as well as throughout the remainder of the draft. So with that being said, let's kick it off with taking a look at the positions so far, as the Detroit Lions have conducted a lot of interviews this offseason. They've interviewed four wide receivers, just a singular offensive lineman, five edge rushers, two interior linemen, one linebacker, four corners, as well as two safeties. Now, starting off with the wide receivers, some of these are combine visits as well, so keep that in mind, but there were updates after the last one that we did, as the Detroit Lions have interviewed four wide receivers so far this offseason, that being Xavier Leggett from the University of South Carolina, who stands at 6'1", 217, with a 9.9 RAS score. Brian Thomas, the 6'5", 198-pound receiver with a 9.83 RAS score. Devontae Walker, the 6'3", 175-pound wide receiver from North Carolina with a 9.76 RAS score, as well as Anthony Gold, a wide receiver that doesn't quite fit like the other ones, standing at just 5'8", 163 pounds with an 8.84 RAS score. Obviously, we know that Brad Holmes loves his big wide receivers. He loves his X's. He loves his, you know, big body field stretchers. He loves the players that can play that role. And unfortunately, he really hasn't found that guy, right? It was supposed to be Tyrell Williams early, and he ended up getting hurt and hasn't played since. It was supposed to be DJ Chark before he left for Carolina. And now the Detroit Lions don't have one. Last year, it was supposed to be Marvin Jones before he stepped away from the Detroit Lions. So potentially, this is a position the Lions are very much still looking for. And I think that there's a good chance that either Brian Thomas could be a first-round pick for the Lions, Xavier Leggett could be a second-round pick, or Devontae Walker could be a third-round selection for the Lions when the draft comes due. But it's very obvious that the Lions want a wide receiver in this class, and it's pretty clear outside of Anthony Gold that they are going to look at a very particular type of wide receiver. They don't want a slot guy. They don't want a skinny Z wide receiver. They want a big, fast, dominant X wide receiver, which is why I think that Troy Franklin and Adonai Mitchell are two players that could potentially be interviewed as well later in the process. Now, moving over to the offensive line, the only offensive lineman that they have signed so far, or they've interviewed so far, excuse me, is Kingsley Suamatala. And if he looks familiar in that BYU uniform, it's because he's actually cousins to Detroit Lions offensive lineman Penei Sewell. With a 9.4 RAS score, standing at 6'6", 315 pounds, Kingsley Suamatala played 381 pass blocking snaps last year at BYU with six hurries and only allowing two sacks. He is a pure left tackle for BYU last season, and as you can see, was a team captain in the Big 12. He is a really good player from everything that I have seen. He is kind of a fringe first-round pick, and I think that if he is available at a certain spot, the Lions will potentially be aggressive to go get the cousin to Penei Sewell, have a long-term solution to Taylor Decker's departure, and potentially pair the two cousins up for long-term success at each tackle position, having bookend tackles for potentially the next decade. But as I said, this is the only offensive lineman that they have actually interviewed the only offensive lineman that they've actually officially talked to and had a private meeting with. He is listed officially by some as a potential guard switch, so that could be really interesting as well. But I do think he has the physical gifts and the physical abilities to be a tackle in the NFL. And I do think it would be a really fun story. And I do think it would be really cool if the Detroit Lions were able to get him and they were able to pair him with Penei Sewell and that bookend tackle actually worked out. Now, with that being said, move on to the edge rusher position. The edge rusher position is a position that the Lions have looked at very heavily in this class. And I think that Brad Holmes is tipping his hand a little bit, saying, hey, this is a position we are going to draft. You might not know who we're going to draft, but we are going to draft some players. And these are two players that at the top that we talked about yesterday as the Dan Campbell guys of this draft class. Darius Robinson stands at 6'5", 285 pounds with a 7.75 RAS score. However, he did grade elite in both the speed and explosiveness categories in that RAS assessment. Braylon Trey stands at 6'3", 245 pounds with a 7.42 RAS score. And although he didn't have anything with the elite categories, his speed and agility grades were both great, while his explosion grade was just a good grade. Now, Braylon Trey is a little bit undersized, which is going to bring down his RAS score a little bit. But again, as we talked about yesterday, I think he plays bigger than he is. He's a great run defender. And both of these players, I think, would be phenomenal on the opposite side of Aiden Hutchinson. A player we haven't yet talked about this offseason, but a player that very much will be talked about at some point, is Marshawn Nealon, the 6'3", 267-pound edge rusher from Western Michigan. Now, despite having just 4.5 sacks last year, Marshawn Nealon graded out with a 9.95 RAS score with elite speed, explosiveness, and agility. On tape, I think he looks a little bit more like an interior rusher personally. I just don't think he has a lot of bend in his game, but he does have a lot of strength, a lot of explosiveness. He is so quick off the line, and everything about his RAS score speaks truly on his tape. He is explosive, he is fast, he is agile, and despite not having the most bend and despite not being necessarily the longest player, I do think he is really explosive, and I do think he could be a really good player for the Detroit Lions. But I think he also might have to transition more to an interior position or play more of that John Kaminsky or Josh Pascal role as opposed to maybe a pure edge rusher in the way that Braylon Trice and Darius Robinson are. Now, the other edge rushers from this class, as I mentioned, there were five. Nelson Caesar, the 6'2", 254-pound edge rusher from Houston, has also been visited. He was a team captain on his team last year at 9.5 sacks, 13.5 tackles for loss. Despite being a little bit small for the edge rusher position, more of that outside linebacker type, he is pretty good at the edge rushing position, and he is projected to go somewhere in the 6th to 7th round, somewhere on day 3. So as a potential replacement for Julian Okwara, I think he could be a really fun player to have, and I think obviously is that Dan Campbell guy being productive, being a leader, being a team captain, and being a voice in the locker room. And then Javon Solomon, a player that's projected to go somewhere on early day 3, late day 2, 6'1", 246 pounds, so a little bit undersized, but last season had 16 sacks and 18 tackles for loss. And even though he had a down year 2 seasons ago, his true sophomore season, he had 11 sacks and I believe 12.5 tackles for loss. So one of the most productive players in this class, a little bit undersized, but a potential day 3 steal for both Nelson Caesar and Javon Solomon. As I've said, the Lions have done a lot of homework and they've done a lot of due diligence on this edge rusher class. I wouldn't be surprised if they brought in even more edge rushers throughout the process. I think they want to get that position shirt away. I think they want to get that guy opposite of Aiden Hutchinson. I think that they are going to do it earlier rather than later in this class, but I also think there are some positions that they could address later. Again, not necessarily getting that bookend defensive guy next to Hutchinson, but getting that rotational pass rusher in Nelson Caesar, getting that rotational guy in Javon Solomon, getting that rotational, flexible, versatile guy in Marshawn Nealon could be options as well in the middle to later stages of the NFL draft. Moving on to interior defensive linemen, the Detroit Lions have interviewed both Johnny Newton as well as Christian Boyd. Johnny Newton, of course, being from the University of Illinois, standing at 6'2", 280 pounds, 7.5 sacks last year, and 8.5 tackles for loss. He was injured throughout the combine process, so we do not have an RAS score on him, but just watching him on the field, he is the best pass rushing interior lineman in this draft. He is a really good athlete, does have some injury concerns, which is obviously concerning, but if he is healthy and on the field, he is one of the best prospects in this class. And I think the injury could lead him to fall to 29. And if you're talking best player available, you're not going to find too many players better than Johnny Newton at the 29th overall pick. And then Christian Boyd is a player that is projected to go sometime on day three, sitting at 6'2", 329 pounds out of the University of Northern Illinois, I believe, who had just 3.5 sacks and 6.5 tackles for loss last year. He's not an exceptional athlete. He is kind of that small school guy, but I do think as a late round selection or potentially even an undrafted free agent, there are some tools to work with. There are some skills to like, and there is some reason to have some expectation for a guy like Christian Boyd in the draft. Again, not an early day one or day two type of player, but as a day three rotational defensive lineman, rotational pass rusher, special teams player, you could be looking at Christian Boyd for that role in particular. Taking a look at the secondary, taking a look at the linebacking core, the Lions have only interviewed one player, and it's Aaron Casey, the 6'1", 231-pound linebacker from Indiana. Despite his very, very poor RAS score of just a 4.27, last year Aaron Casey had 109 tackles, 20 tackles for loss, 6.5 sacks, 3 forced fumbles, and even though he's not the most athletically gifted linebacker, his instincts are really strong. He's a very strong tackler, very refined as a player, and I'm not sure if he was a team captain or not. I don't believe Indiana actually wears the captaincies on his jerseys, but I would not be surprised at all if Aaron Casey was a captain on that defense, being an older member, being one of the most productive linebackers, and again, potentially being a leader in the locker room. Now, going on to the secondary, this time, the Lions have interviewed three prospects as well as one CFL player. Now we'll talk about the three prospects first. Kool-Aid McKinstry, 5'11", 199, 7.52 RAS score, but that is to be taken with a little bit of a grain of salt because he did run his 40 and do his drills with a broken bone in his foot. So having a 7'5 with a broken foot is pretty solid overall considering what Kool-Aid McKinstry has shown on film. They've interviewed Kenyon Mitchell as well, the 6', 195-pound cornerback from the University of Toledo. A 9.8 RAS score is the exact kind of athlete that Brad Holmes and Dan Campbell love to bring in. I'm not sure he's going to be there at 29, but if he is, I think he is a big part of the Detroit Lions plans, and I do think he will be a very highly regarded prospect on their big board. And then a player that I actually have an undrafted grade on, and that being Nyheim Pritchard, I believe is how you say it, the cornerback from Auburn, 6', 190 pounds, a 7.72 RDS score. Nothing about him to me really stands out on tape that much. I think he could be a really good special teamer. I think he could be a really good seventh round pick for the Detroit Lions as a core special teams guy, potentially a little bit of cornerback depth, but I don't think they would be drafting him in order to have him play coverage snaps. I don't think they draft him very high at all. Potentially as a UDFA player, you might say, okay, why are you using your top 30 visit on a UDFA? They did that quite a bit last year. Guys like Adrian Martinez was a top 30 visit. There were quite a few UDFAs that they're trying to do their due diligence on. You can only draft so many players in the top 100 or 256. So obviously in your top 30 picks, you're not going to spend all of them on players in the first and second rounds. You're going to want some variety. And I think that he is a potential late round steal or potential UDFA player for the Detroit Lions for a camp battle. And then, although I don't have it written down, the Detroit Lions have also brought in CFL cornerback Quantez Stiggers for an interview. And I don't know very much about Quantez. I don't have very much CFL film, so I can't watch very much about him, but that is also something to monitor as we move forward. And then the last couple of players for this position and the last couple of players that the Lions have interviewed so far are going to be Stoney Vaca, the 5'11", 200-pound safety from Utah, as well as Malik Mustafa, the 5'10", 209-pound safety out of Wake Forest. Now, Stoney Vaca, again, 5'11", 210 pounds, a 7.88 RAS score with elite grades in the explosiveness category. Malik Mustafa has not done any athletic testing, so there is no official RAS score, but again, stands at 5'10", 209 pounds. Over this three-year career at Wake Forest, has 3 interceptions and 4 forced fumbles. He is a player that forces some turnovers. Again, a potential late-round special teams type of player. The Lions are looking to fill out that roster at the bottom, and I do think that Mustafa could be either a seventh round pick or a potential undrafted free agent that they like to have on the special team. So with all of that being said, that is every player the Detroit Lions have interviewed so far for their draft process. It's a lot of players, again, very heavy at wide receiver, very heavy at edge rusher, pretty light on defensive tackle and offensive line. I think that they feel pretty good about the interior of their defensive line and really good about their offensive line, at least for this season. Secondary has a couple of guys, but the edge rushers and the wide receivers are definitely an area of focus and could very well be the top two picks for the Detroit Lions in their 2024 class. But with all of that being said, that is all I have for you guys today. Let me know down in the comments below how you feel about this draft, how you feel about these interviews. How do you feel about the players that Brad Holmes is potentially looking at? Are any of these players on your radar as potential steals or just players that you want to see wearing Honolulu blue next season? I'd be very curious what you guys have to say and how you guys feel about the visits. But with all of that being said, that's all I got for you guys right now. Thank you all so much for watching. And until next time, and as always...